right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me now is Paul Pedersen, the CEO of Nextleaf Solutions. And Paul, it's good to have you back.
Thanks for having me this morning, Steve.
Well, we want to talk a little bit about patents and intellectual property. You and I have talked a lot about in the past, but we want to expand a bit more on that. So first off, why don't you just touch on some of your recent successes as far as patents are concerned, back in June?
Yeah, absolutely. So Nextleaf recently hit the milestone of our 40th issued patent. And, you know, for us, it's very exciting. We received our first issued patent about a year and a half ago. And back in June, we received our main patent, which covers the extraction, refinement, and distillation of cannabinoids. We received this patent, or were granted it, I should say, across Europe. So across Europe, in Asia. And for us, obviously, we've already been issued the patent in Australia, Canada, and the United States. So, the IP for us really supports our global strategy. And around that, it's an asset-light, IP-heavy global strategy. And we're very excited because, Europe is a major jurisdiction for cannabis. If you look ahead 5 years, and I really believe that you may actually see legalization happen in Europe before it happens in the United States. So for us, I think our entry into that market is first getting our IP protected, and then looking for opportunities to always export from Canada where cannabis is federally legal. So our IP strategy really ties into our commercial strategy quite well. And just it's been awesome to see the traction that our director of IP and our R&D team has been having with their success and our issued patent success rate over the last year.
Paul, let's talk about the industry in general. Can you tell me a bit about how extensive patents are within the cannabis industry, and how do you sort of stack up against those of your peers within cannabis as far as intellectual property is concerned?
You know, it's really interesting. I think I've been in the cannabis industry now almost 7 years, and What is remarkable to this day is that there still isn't a lot of companies focused on patents and intellectual property. I think we hear the term innovation a lot. I mean, that's a buzzword that companies throw out, and we hear intellectual property, but there hasn't been a lot of companies that have had success in turning intellectual property into issued patents. And proud of the fact that our company is second in the industry to Canopy Growth in total issued patents related to cannabinoids, and we are first when it comes to issued patents related specifically to extraction. And obviously Canopy, I think their last release, they said 150 issued patents, and even our former premier Christy Clark, when she joined the board of Constellation Brands, which is obviously the kind of the controlling shareholder of Canopy Growth, she mentioned one of the reasons that she liked the company was their focus on intellectual property. And we obviously agree with Christy. And for us, that's been a big focus. And we really see ourselves as sort of being ahead of the curve. I think, Steve, in 3 years, when you look at this industry, you will see more cannabis companies that are focusing on IP and focusing on developing the issued patents, because simply that's what you see in other industries, right? That's what you see in biotech and in life sciences and in pharma. And cannabis without patents is farming, it's agriculture. And I think, companies that aspire to be billion-dollar businesses do so developing proprietary and unique differentiated IP. And that's really been our focus since day one as a company.
Paul, do you think it's really important as an industry, especially a fairly new industry, to have more patents put on things? Because the cannabis industry really started off as sort of the wild west of everything, where it was, very black market. It was all underground and people could do what they want. But as you say, when you start developing an industry and you start stacking yourselves up against biotech and other things like that, having patents and sort of the regulations around it, especially when you're trying to, have the general public consuming something, I think becomes even more important. Would you agree with that?
Absolutely. And, the herbal form of cannabis by its definition has a very wide variance, right? And I think You know, that's been the challenge with medicinal cannabis and kind of pharmaceutical based companies. I mean, even Shoppers Drug Mart, when you listen to them speak about the industry, I mean, the variability in what's in those products are very concerning, because, you know, again, pharmacists are used to giving their customers a drug that has the same, the same consistency, right? From batch to batch, lot to lot. You don't see that in herbal form. So we think with the focus now getting into derivative products, getting into oil, you know, companies that can standardize and can differentiate with a repeatable process. So, you know, their products would be the same batch after batch. We think is really what's going to allow us to come, you know, mass market from both a medicinal perspective, but also an adult use or recreational perspective. I mean, you know, you touched on it. Cannabis isn't a new industry. It's just the legal market is new federally, right? And you know, even if you look south of the border, you know, cannabis, people forget, is still federally illicit on these, you know, Schedule One lists. You know, companies can't cross state lines. They can't export. And more importantly, there's no federal regulation. So there's really a lack of standards. And we really think that that creates a big opportunity for Canadian companies like Nextleaf, because of the federal status of cannabinoids in the United States. There really has been a lack of R&D, a lack of intellectual property development. So there's a tremendous amount of IP that just simply hasn't been registered. And for us, I think we've been very successful in doing it, what we call a technology transfer from the legacy market, taking IP, scaling it up with our team of engineers and chemists, and you know, building it into what has become now 40 issued patents and over 60 pending patents. And you know, that has been a big part of our strategy, and we really think that what it allows us to do is to differentiate with our solutions and our technology.
Paul, so if I'm hearing you correctly, what you're saying is that intellectual property and patents should be part of your global strategy, whether it's production, manufacturing, marketing, everything you would do within a company. This has to be another phase of it as well, and continue with that strategy worldwide.
For sure. And, you know, we really view the opportunity here, that there's a greater opportunity for us as a company to sell the means to production versus simply selling cannabis, right? And what I mean by the means to production, I mean, what our IP portfolio is what we believe to be the most efficient method to get from, you know, dried cannabis biomass into that refined oil through to a THC or CBD based distillate, you know, tasteless, odorless, you know, high purity, that's now ready to be dropped into a number of infused products. And so our IP covers that process and a number of pieces of equipment that are essential through the refinement, right? And for us, it's not about taking high quality dried cannabis and turning it into oil. It's about taking the lower grade product. I mean, there's a lot of that across the industry. And so I think not just in cannabis, but in other industries, you know, how you become more efficient is you take the lower grade inventory and you convert that into a higher grade output that can be sold as a value add product. And that's really what our IP is about. And for us, we think there's going to be a tremendous opportunity to monetize that IP through licensing agreements. So when I say we have global aspirations, I mean, our focus as a business is Canada, where obviously we have the most well-developed cannabis market anywhere in the world. And the Canadian regulations allow us to export product anywhere in the world. But in addition to, we see there being opportunities to license some of our IP to other jurisdictions where Nextleaf doesn't operate. We've been generating revenue through IP licensing now for over half a year, and are always looking for strategic partners in other areas. And that's really what I think the big benefit in IP is. It's a very efficient way to generate revenue for the business and cash flows in a way that's really an asset light sort of model. We're not focused on building greenhouses. We're not focused on global domination by setting up facilities in all these foreign countries. We're focused on our processing facility, our extraction plant in Coquitlam, BC, and then expanding globally through IP licensing.
Well, it's pretty exciting. Thanks for the insight into this. I think it really really says something about what you're doing and why intellectual property and patents are really so important. Paul, thanks so much. Great to talk to you again. We'll talk again soon.
Thank you very much, Steve.
All right, Paul Pedersen, the CEO of Nextleaf Solutions.